I'm out here doing DIY mini split installation, and I had to order a manifold gauge set in order to draw a vacuum and measure for leaks as part of the installation process. And this is what it looks like when you unbox it. Have our lines, the gauges, and for this job, I'm just going to be using the blue side, which looks to me like the low pressure side. And I have one of these, hopefully will be the adapter for the AC unit for my R410A refrigerant. Maybe this one. All right, let's set it up and see if it works. So yes, indeed, that one does work. That's the R410 adapter. Then I can just attach the blue line in there. So that's great news. All right, there it is hooked up, and comes with a little hanger there. Yeah, I got the blue, my low pressure side, running over into the R410 adapter. Got it hooked in. On the wet side here, the yellow cord goes into my Harbor Freight Pittsburgh vacuum pump. And now we're gonna vacuum it down and see if we can get down to the negative 76 we need to and hold that seal. All right, so I have the vacuum pump running. And by the way, remember to turn the valve open, I guess, before you turn on the vacuum pump. Maybe not. I don't know. It's a good question how you're supposed to do it. Either way, it looks like it's pulling a vacuum here. It's about 60. It says to leave it for 15 or 20 minutes in the Senville instruction, down to 76. And well, we'll see how that goes. One key point that I just discovered for using manifold gauges on a DIY AC unit install, this little knob here on the low side, if you leave it open, it leaves open the passageway between your low side pressure measure and your vacuum pump. So obviously the pressure is dropping and it's not in my low side like I thought it was as I was chasing leaks. It's in my vacuum pump. So if I close it down, I don't have that issue anymore. So yeah, you need to open the valve in order to draw the vacuum, but in order to test if the vacuum's holding, got to screw it back down, because then you more than likely your leak is in your vacuum pump, not in the line. I know that's probably basic for people that are AC technicians or have done this kind of thing before on automotive, but for somebody just trying to finish up the mini split installation and vacuum those lines out, key point.